municipal zoning. They're boxier, they're more like the 6 to 12 story tenement buildings that are in our neighborhood, or the 6 to 7 story brownstones that are in the neighborhood, depending on the block. So, let's touch on our current zoning for a bit. Our current zoning is mostly R8. The R stands for residential, and the 8 describes the level of density. 8 is pretty high. Maximum number is maybe 10, 11, 12. We're at an 8. So we already have a very high density neighborhood, and we like that, I would imagine. That's part of the reason we all live here, is because we want to live in Manhattan. If we wanted to live in a less dense neighborhood, we would live in the suburbs or far out from you or something. But we live in a dense neighborhood. Some of it, a few portions are R7, which is lower density, and in our area, they also have additional parking requirements that I've gone. So, but we have R7 or R8, there is no contextual requirement, though. So again, these can be towers built as high as they want. Residential also allows for what's known as community facility space. These include things like medical offices, schools, educational use, and if you listen to that, medical and educational use in churches. And if you listen to that, this is a neighborhood with St. Luke's, Riverside Church, Union Theological Seminary, Jewish Theological Seminary, Barnard College, Columbia, Teachers College, Bank Street. We have a lot of community facility space that's in these residential zones and it's permitted. So we went over the potential for towers. So our proposed zoning proposes a hard height cap on every inch of Morningside Heights. And these height caps were gotten from the surrounding buildings on the block. So where we're proposing R9A zoning, the A there indicates it's contextual. It has a height limit of 17 stories. So some of the buildings along Broadway are 16 stories. The closest match to them is R9A with 17 stories. R8A has a height limit of 12 stories in most places. R8B, the B you can think of as standing for brownstone, has a height limit of 7 stories, and it's mostly for brownstone townhouse blocks in the mid-block. And then finally, R7A has a height cap of 8 stories, and that's for the lower slum, more tenant-style blocks that are in our neighborhood. So you have the high 12 to 16-story blocks that are frequently co-ops or tall buildings along Broadway or Amsterdam, like Stonehenge. You have R7A for tenants. You have R8B for brownstones. I'm going to try to stick to the layman's terms, but if you hear me slip into those R9A and R8A, just stop. And one last thing, affordable housing was mentioned. Any time that we're moving from a 7 to an 8, or an 8 to a 9, any time that number goes up, any new building built on that lot that is residential must include affordable housing. So that's where we get mandatory inclusionary housing, is any time that density number goes up, developers must build affordable housing in new residential building there. So, it's important to think about, though, when this zoning will be used. We've had our current zoning for 50-plus years, 57 years. So we need this zoning to last. So when will it be used? When there's a soft site, like Robert went over, that's like a parking lot or low-slum commercial buildings where there aren't residential tenants that can't be evicted. If you think about the old Chase Bank on 112th Street by the Citibank that burned down, if you think about the Coronet's Pizza, Panda Express, Banco Popular buildings right on 11th Street and Broadway, those are all soft sites that could easily be torn down and redeveloped. Also, if there is a catastrophe, God forbid, such as fire or something else that requires an existing building to be torn down, any building that replaces it will be built under these new rules. And then finally, if an institution decides to tear down a building currently used for community facility space, the replacement building must conform to the new regulations. So in the event that we have hospitals shrinking all across the city, in the event that St. Luke's decides to sell more of its buildings, they're already begun, if they get torn down, what will be built where those buildings were must comply with these new regulations that we're proposing. So, and then finally, I mentioned affordable housing. Because most of Morningside is R8, we only get affordable housing when we move up to R9, unless we're going from a 7 to an 8. So anytime, again, that middle number goes up, you start to require affordable housing. But even though we're increasing density in some areas, we are requiring affordable housing and we are getting a height cap. So even though there may be slightly more square footage, you have a hard height ceiling, and that means no more towers. So let's get into it. Let's go block by block. And if you have comments or questions, please don't raise your hand. Please write them on the comment card. We're going to try to go through every block of the neighborhood as fast as we can without while still going over everything. So we're going to begin. Yes, if you want an additional card, if you need a card, please raise your hand. We're going to begin in the southwest corner of the neighborhood on the block that is bounded by 110th to 111th Street from Broadway to Riverside. This is right at the very lower corner, right at where the subway is. So also some more tenants, International House, and there's a garage right here on Claremont. So the existing buildings on this block already go up to 21 stories, especially that Manhattan School Music Tower there. We are proposing R7A between Broadway and Claremont. So if you look at this building, if you look at this block of tenements, these are all 6 or 7 stories. We're proposing that they be limited to 8 stories, and the reason is we do not want to incentivize landlords to harass out tenants to tear down those buildings and build bigger buildings. So if they're already at 6 or 7 stories, there's no incentive for them to do that if we cap them at 8 stories. So we're proposing an 8-story cap between Broadway and Claremont. However, between Claremont and Riverside, over the International House and the garage, we are proposing R9A. And we think that in the event that that garage gets sold to a developer, we want to require affordable housing be put there. And so that's why we're proposing R9A. It also will not be much taller than International House and certainly be shorter at 17 stories than the MSM Tower right there. All right, and then the same kind of style block from LaSalle to Tienen and from Broadway to Riverside. We have Claremont Avenue running through right here. These existing buildings are all about 6 stories. Again, there is no height cap and no affordability required currently. So a developer could harass out all the tenants, tear down one of these buildings, and build a tower. We are proposing that this be rezoned to R7A. Again, that's an 8-story height cap. So there's no incentive to tear down those buildings, and we want to work to make sure that the affordable housing that's already in those buildings, because many of them are unstabilized, for HDFCs, we want to make sure that they stay affordable. So we're proposing an R7A height with an 8-story height cap over this block with Salatine and Broadway Riverside. Finally, last block in our first third of the district is this little wedge here between Broadway and Riverside, Tienen and 125th Street. You have the 125th Street corridor here, which is mostly Columbia, and this is the McDonald's on that block. And of course, 560 Riverside on the end of it. 560 Riverside is 26 stories. Everything else is about 6 stories. We are proposing that this block be capped at 8 stories, except the McDonald's. We are proposing that the McDonald's be zoned R9A, which is 17 stories, and would require affordable housing. So in the event that any residential building is built on that lot, we want there to be affordable housing, and it will still be shorter than 560 Riverside. It will also be facing Columbia's new campus, which is fairly high density and fairly tall. So we feel that a 17-story affordable housing building is more appropriate there than either the current tower that could be built there or a luxury building of 8 stories, which would be on the north side. So again, everything besides McDonald's, capped at 8 stories. The McDonald's, capped at 17 stories, requiring affordable housing. So we're moving over to the middle portion between Broadway and Amsterdam. We have here grant houses from LaSalle, 125th Street, Amsterdam, and Broadway. It's currently zoned R7. But the sad fact is that NYCHA, as a state authority, is not bound by New York City zoning regulations. So, you know, we are proposing an R7A there, but ultimately, no matter what we propose, it won't matter, because NYCHA can do what they want on their land without regard to our zoning code. From 123rd to LaSalle, Amsterdam to Broadway, is Morningside Gardens. So these buildings are 21 stories. The current zoning is R72, which is lower density than R8. The 2 just means that they require on-site parking to be built. They have maxed out their density. We do not have a proposed zoning for this area yet. And part of the reason we do not is because we feel like we would like more time to conduct additional outreach to residents of Morningside Gardens and maybe hold a meeting in the gardens, which would be its own separate thing. So we do not have yet a proposed zoning for that block. For 122nd to 123rd, Amsterdam to Broadway, this is where JTS is, this is where that Savannah building's going up. This has Max Cafe on the end here on Broadway. And Jeanette next to it along those Rosemont buildings. We are proposing R7A, eight-story height limit. That's in line with what's there existing, and it would have prevented the Savannah Tower had we gotten it in beforehand. We do not think that any additional development on that block should be allowed, given that Savannah Tower going up. The block below that, 121st to 122nd, Amsterdam to Broadway, where we stand now. This has Corpus Christi Church, it has that big tower in the middle that's Teachers College housing, it has that Vino, the wine store on Amsterdam Avenue. We are proposing, so that Teachers College housing is 21 stories already. We are proposing, again, an eight-story height limit with no affordability required for this block. Why an eight-story height limit? It already has excessive building from both the Teachers College housing and the Savannah building going up on the next block, and also Goldsmith Hall. Robert mentioned that earlier, that's on this block. We do not want to provide an incentive to the developer to tear down that building. So with an eight-story height cap, Goldsmith Hall would presumably stay as it is and not be torn down.